Welcome to the Mr. Peter Parker Show. Is it Monday?
Yeah.
Feels like a Friday, but I'm in here on a Monday. It's your boy, 3 to 7 weekdays. We got to go local. Your girl's making moves all over the world. You heard her on projects with other superstars. Now she got her little superstar wave. Lexii Alijai, please, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
How you feeling? What's up?
I'm good. I'm nervous, kind of, just because.
For what?
Oh, just all the pressure coming.
What's pressure?
No, not here. Online, like just, you know.
Like I said, what's pressure?
I get nervous because I'm still young, you know, like.
Oh, my goodness.
I know. See,
nervous?
I'm working on it, yeah.
Nervous is like praying for the worst to happen.
Mm-hmm.
You should be embracing this moment. You got an amazing wave, an amazing new project, beautiful young lady.
Thank you.
Everybody respect you and love you. Like everybody's little sis.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good thing to be.
Yeah.
People looking out for you, people watching you.
Right.
There's a lot of, I would say, I probably think you feel the pressure from the expectations.
Pressure as in, like, let me say, I feel like I'm not doing enough. So I really beat myself
up. I agree. You could do a little bit more, but you're doing phenomenal. And the quality of what you do is so high, it probably makes up for maybe some of the lack of product. People have been waiting on music for a while, but what I always know about you is when you put something out, it's always dope. It's always thoughtful.
Thank you.
So, like, I think, like, less is more.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And great project. You got this Growing Pains out right now. How much does this project mean to you?
It means a lot because it's, like, it was just, it represents an era in my life that I had to grow out of and just how bad it hurts. I almost said a cuss word. Sorry, I'm working on it. You know, just growing out of old relationships, growing up even, you know, and it's like it hurts, but you got to like grow.
Yeah.
And I also feel like it was such a stretch from the last time that I dropped. It's like, I feel like people are also growing with me because it's one of my best projects.
Yeah. You're such a tough cookie, but a sensitive person. And it's
I'm
both.
A Pisces.
You're,
I'm really
you're very both, like very bold and confident. But when I hear the music and the stories and some of the things that you've been through, you're not afraid to like talk about insecurities or difficult moments in your life and sharing them. And I think your listeners really like the kids and the girls that listen are like, you speak on behalf of them.
Mm-hmm.
They're going through the same things.
Yeah.
Do you feel like that's a need? Like you really feel a necessity to like share that personal stuff?
I do because I feel like it's just been so long since a female rapper has not tried to sell sex or talk about her sex or like money or you know what I mean? So it's like at the end of the day, these grown women who are rapping like that, they've been in love. They deal with heartbreak and they just don't really talk about it. So I feel like, I don't know, I guess I just want a loyal fan base.
Yeah.
And I feel like the kind of stuff I'm putting out, I have loyal fans who.
And you're real, you're sincere. Like,
Thank you.
As far as an MC, I know your J. Cole influences and stuff, but you really kept it true to like the bars. Like you're really like an MC's MC. You really rap on these records. It's, you're not like, oh, I sing a little bit, I rap a little bit. No, no, you're a rapper.
Mm-hmm.
And you take care in your craft. When I hear you, I can hear it. Like, what's your favorite song on the project?
Oh man, people ask me that all the time. You know, I'm like my worst critic. And these records, like you'd be surprised. Like a lot of them are a little old. So it's like, I was just already just put it out, but I was waiting on something that promises from other people. And I just was waiting on them. And then I was just like, you know what? Nobody helped me record this album.
Let's do it.
Nobody's helped me pay for anything. So I just put it out by myself.
Yeah. And it's everywhere right now. I got it on Tidal. It's on Apple Music.
Yep. And I'm keeping the whole 100%, which is, you know.
That's it. That's how you're supposed to do it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Keeping every dollar, you put everything into it, you're taking everything out. That's what Jay talks about when I read a lot of Jay-Z interviews and articles and things. It's ownership.
Yeah.
Like, it's all about ownership.
Definitely.
Like, owning your product, owning your album forever. Like, we got to the point in this culture where opportunities were given to people, but at a certain point, you want to regain control
right,
of what you're doing. And you're starting in that position.
That was my plan, too. So this one kind of happened on accident because with everything that was kind of going so bad, I felt like I did want to jump. If somebody's pushing X amount of dollars in front of your face and you can't even pay your own phone bill sometimes, like,
no way.
You're going to want it. You know what I'm saying? It's tempting, but it's like, I knew, like, they're going to want that back. It's not like you're just giving. And I feel like I'm more than a $60,000 artist. You know what I mean? Like,
that's nothing. No, no, for real, but when somebody dangles things in the beginning, you go, okay, if they're going to offer me this, the first radio job I ever got offered was Market 126, Fayetteville, North Carolina, J. Cole's hometown, $20,000 a year for 3-year contract. I said, you know what? Sounds like a great opportunity. Not for me. Thanks for the opportunity. And 6 months later, I was on B96.
Wow. See, that's my problem. I'm not a B-I-T-C-H yet. I can't tell people, like, no, like, Nicki Minaj, I watch her interviews. No.
But that's not being a... That's being...
Let me say a businesswoman. I don't know how to make decisions and not...
You're too nice for the industry.
My feelings, yeah. I be thinking like, oh, like they're going to be sad if I don't want them to manage me.
Music business. Mm-hmm. Not music friends, not music feelings, not music family. Music business. Mm-hmm. That's what you're participating in. Not music friends.
Yeah.
And then it gets blurred mm-hmm. because these people are our friends. Like, make me and you are friends, but this is also promotion.
Right.
It's business. You mm-hmm. know what I mean? For your album that you own 100% on. See what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, watch that, though. But you growing up. What's the album called? Growing Pains.
Growing Pains, exactly.
You figuring it out. That's why I got to give her a little bit of game when you come through. You're way too dope for us to not let you be the superstar you're supposed to be.
I also, a part of the Growing Pains, too, is part of you saying me growing up. Is like, I went through a deep-ass depression recently, actually. And the album just like, man, like, it hurt. You know what I'm saying? Like, and it's like, people don't really understand with that decision, you know what I mean? I had three different options in front of my face, which all were like, damn, like this probably could change my life in a week, but like, now it's probably, you know, it's a little bit of a delay now, but.
Nah, watch, patience. You got something very, very special, amazing local artist. Where did you grow up out here? Like what neighborhood?
St. Paul.
Yeah?
East Side. Well, Frogtown.
Okay.
Frogtown and East Side. My mom lived on the East Side. My grandma lived in Frogtown.
Yeah, man.
So I was like, you know, in between the two areas.
I'm hip.
Yep.
Nah, you putting on for a lot of people, and I know there's so many kids inspired by what you do. Being a young woman, making these type of accomplishments, going on stage with Kehlani, she's mm-hmm. bringing you out.
Yeah.
Sometimes we're like, does she even know, like, how popping this is?
You know what? I think she does, because she, like
I say
somebody,
she, when I say she, I'm talking about you.
Me, yes. No, I do, but I do doubt myself sometimes just because I'm human, you know?
Of course.
But I do believe in myself. Like,
I know you do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And somebody said, like, if you're not feeling yourself, how you expect everybody else to feel you, you know? So.
Yeah, right in the edge, though, that Growing Pains, man, you've made amazing strides since I've met you. I remember in the beginning, you didn't even want to come in here.
I wasn't ready. Like, that's probably when I didn't know that I could really rap, you know?
Oh, yeah.
But I've got a lot better since then. Anyways.
Yeah, you been, though. But I love it, like, the high standard that you set for yourself and where you want to be mm-hmm. and where you want to go. You've always had a vision for that since I've met you.
Yeah, I think so, too. I think now I'm just finally starting to take action. Like,
you're killing it. We're super proud of you. We can't wait to get you involved. Come on, man. You're
I know. I'm trying to get some shows, Peter Parker.
It's happening. I'm cooking them up right now. I got you.
Man.
We're trying to bring I can't spill the beans yet, but I got one for you. So let's get into this record. It's on the album right now. That's out everywhere. Growing Pains. Can you introduce this song for the Twin Cities?
Okay, Twin Cities. This is my record. It's called Love Sucks. There's a bit of profanity on it, but it's all clean and edited out for you, so I hope you like it.
Right, you edited this for the radio, right?
Yeah, definitely.
See, what I'm trying to figure it out for her, man.
It's all clean. I'm not that slow.
It's happening right now. We're gone local. Lexii Alijai, clap for her, please. Young superstar making it happen. We're incredibly proud of you.
Thank you.
Amazing.